mostly almost every day. I think my health are also tired of it. 2 weeks and then I had a small intestine infection. Make sure you soak the almond in the water, because not only is it better, also the outer coating is not good for you. Oh my God, I can like literally, yeah.
Staying in shape can be a lot harder than you think. And while some people do work hard for it, it comes naturally to a few of them. And from what I know, Moni is definitely one of them. So welcome to Pink Villa, Moni.
Hello Priyanka, how are you?
And I'm really good. Moni told us that she eats a lot during the day. So we had to find out what she actually eats in a day. So I'm going to ask you a few questions and you can be quick about it.
Okay.
A morning ritual that you follow.
I wake up, have water with haldi. Then if I have, within half an hour, I have hot water with cinnamon powder. Nothing. Then I finish my yoga and my morning ritual, and then I have mostly almost every day. I think my healths are also tired of it. They make me poha, like one small bowl of poha and this much sprouts. They make it in an Indian way and then they give me. That's my staple breakfast.
Every day.
You don't
get bored of it.
Not really. I have sometimes I order from Zomato if I'm like very, or you know, at shoots sometimes whatever the set ka nashta is, I love eating a little bit, but that's my staple. I love doing that.
I think you're one of the very few people who actually eat like the same breakfast every day.
Yeah, almost every day. Yeah.
So a workout that you swear by the most?
Yoga. Yoga and I don't know, a lot of breathing. So yeah.
Because Ashtang, we feel practice. You looking fabulous in gym clothes, I must tell you.
thank you.
Please break down what you eat in a day, like from the minute.
Really? Okay, so yeah. Poha and that happens. Then, which I'm trying to leave now, I love my coffee. I used to have 3 cups of coffee, now I have cut down to 1 and I want to get rid of that as well.
That's quite difficult.
Yeah, so I have like a big cup of coffee with 1.5 scoop of hazelnut syrup. And then it's usually lunchtime. So there I have a full meal, one bowl of rice with all the possible sabjis that has dal, saag, sabji, everything. It's full Bengali meal. Then after that, if I feel hungry, I have a fruit. Then after that also I feel hungry, I have lots of dry fruits, one full mutti. They are the best source of vitamins. One must have actually 2 mutti of
dry fruits.
But make sure you soak the almond in the water, because not only is it better, also the outer coating is not good for you. Like it is some kind of poison, they say. You can Google about it and read. So always soak it in water for 5-6 hours and then eat it. See, if I'm on shoot and sometimes there's set ka nashta, a lot of, I won't lie, I'd have that noodles or whatever that's come, something chatpata. Or if I'm home and I feel very hungry before dinner, I'd have a little bit of bhel also. Properly made, nicely made with like...
chutneys and all.
Not really too many chutneys, but say some fried onions and cucumbers and some tomatoes. It's yum. And then I have my dinner and then I go to sleep. And if after lunch, sometimes I feel like I have an Olinguri Shondesh also some days.
Are there any special diets or ritual you follow while traveling or on sets, or you know, if you have
not really, if I know that I have to be in a certain shape, then just I avoid carbs, that's all. But other than that, no, I have not. You know, honestly, diets have not worked out for me. It's not like that. I have tried everything in the world. I think when I did keto, I did it about 2 weeks and then I had a small intestine infection. When I'm not eating rice, I'm such a crabby person. I can't concentrate on anything that's happening. I feel like, I genuinely feel like you should do something that you can do all your life. Finally, in the last 1.5 years, I have come to, and also my nutritionist, she's really, really helped me. She's given me these cups of what should be what quantity. So, and I've realized that, you know, not really, if I stick to that, not that I'm losing weight, but I don't put on either. So I have finally found, I think, my balance.
And your cheat meals?
Which also I have 3 times in a week, I think. Fries with piri piri. Earlier I used to only order from, you know, McDonald's or somewhere else. But now my helps know how to make it. And I just add the piri piri in it and I have.
Your favorite cuisine?
Bengali food, mummy ke haath ka khana, and Chinese also actually. I love a good Chinese meal. I actually also really love Italian food. Sorry.
Sucker for a pizza.
Pizza, more than pizza, I think it's the pastas. I love the aglio olio fusilli and made in pesto. oh my god, I can like literally, yeah.
So lastly, was there any special ritual that you followed for, you know, Brahmastra or Patli Kamari or anything like that?
So Brahmastra initially, before we started shooting, it was, you know, we had to do some sort of training, and there were people allotted. Kuldeep, in fact, he's one person who helped me out a lot. In fact, I was again battling with a lot of injuries at that very point in time. Patli Kamari, like I said, I kept at it for my... I was doing my daily exercise practices, and just the food bit I managed for about a week.
Thank you so much, Moni.
Thank you.
It was great talking to you. I think I've known everything about you right now.
Yeah.
I feel that.
Yeah.
So thank you so much for chatting with us. Thank you so much, guys. Comment below and let us know what else would you like to know about Moni. And we'll try to
I don't think they want to know anything more. That's enough.
Thank you so much, guys. Stay tuned for more updates.